Howdy, y'all. It's Daniel back once again making an extra tutorial based on questions asked in the Camtasia certification Slack group. I get this question from time to time. Hey, D, I've got this smaller image or video superimposed over my screencast, kind of picture in picture, if you will, and I want to zoom in on it, but I don't want it filling up my canvas. In other words, I want to keep the frame the same, but zoom the content. And as it happens, we can accomplish this by way of media mats. So here in Camtasia, I've got this screencast up and also a small video down here in the corner. Obviously, the screencast portion can be zoomed to whatever size we want, as the only real constraint here is the size of the canvas. Now, here in the smaller video, say I wanted to zoom in on this person's face. If I zoom in the usual way, eventually it's going to fill up my canvas. I don't want that. I want to zoom, but I want the frame to stay exactly the same down here in this little corner. We're going to use a media mat to artificially constrain the size of this video window. To do this, we need a shape to act as the video's mat. I'll just grab a shape annotation here, and we'll make it the same size and location as the video. And just to make it stand out, let's make it a funky color. Now that we've got a shape placed over our video, we need to ensure that it's on the very next track. In other words, one just above our video, and that it's synchronized with our video. Same duration, same in and out points. After that, we just need to make the shape a media mat. We go to Visual Effects and apply the media mat effect. You can see that the color has disappeared and the video is visible again. So, what's happening here? Well, basically, our shape is now invisible, and it is instead being used to determine what part of the media just below it is actually visible. Don't believe me? Watch as I resize the mat. Or I can even change its shape. Well, that's perhaps a little extreme. But how about, let me see, adding a bit of corner rounding? Yeah, that looks good. Now, let's zoom in on this guy here. So I'll add an animation point. Now we scale and recenter on our guy here. And now, time for the magic. Lovely. And drag it out to a few seconds in length. We can zoom, we can pan, we can do whatever to the video, and it all stays within the confines of our shape. Okay, let me do a couple of quick little things to wrap it up. First, I think I want a border. Now, I can't add a border visual effect to the shape or to the video itself because it won't show up. But what I can do is make a border layer based on my shape. So I come over to my mat here and I just duplicate it and drag the track below my video. At this point, the screencast disappears because this copy also has a mat currently. So we take it off. Good. And then scale up the new shape just a touch. Also, we might want to change the color to something slightly less obnoxious. Okay. And finally, as a general housekeeping measure, let's select these three pieces of media, the border, the video, and the mat, and group them. That way, we have a self-contained set that we can move around and resize at will. So, that does it for this one. Give us a like or subscribe if you dig this, and if you want to really ramp up your screencasting, don't forget to get your Camtasia certifications, which are free to all holders of a Camtasia maintenance agreement. They are 10 full hours of the best screencasting education around. See you soon.